Appreciate Bill giving me this spot. My social secretary and I got confused this time. It's simple for me. As soon as I get here in June, I take every Monday on the calendar through January, I write Hoot. So I never accept anything for that day. And Margaret does it 1 month at a time, and I guess she forgot to do it for December, and she'd accepted an invitation for tonight for some people to honor some people who are leaving, and she'd accepted it before she looked and saw it was a Monday. So I'm going to eat, got to sing and run. When I sing, you may want me to run. As I sat down one evening, 'twas in a small cafe, where a 40-year-old waitress to me these words did say. I see you are a logger, and not just a common bum, for nobody but a logger stirs coffee with his thumb. I had a logger lover, there's none like him today. If you poured whiskey on it, he'd eat a bale of hay. He never shaved a whisker from off of his horny hide. He hammered in the bristles and bit them off inside. My logger came to see me, 'twas on a winter's day. He held me in a fond embrace that broke three vertebrae. He kissed me when we parted, so hard he broke my jaw. I couldn't speak to tell him he forgot his Mackinaw. I saw my logger lover go striding through the snow, a-going gaily homeward at 48 below. The weather tried to freeze him, it tried its level best. At 100 degrees below zero, he buttoned up his vest. It froze clear down to China, it froze to the stars above. At 1,000 degrees below zero, it froze my logger love. They did their best to thaw him, but if you'll believe it, sir, they did their best to saw him, but if you'll believe it, sir, they made him into axe blades to chop the Douglas fir. And so I lost my lover, and to this cafe I've come, and here I watch for someone who stirs coffee with his thumb. Thank you. Now, the reason I particularly wanted to sing that song, quite a few of you in this room probably know Jack, Bill, or Ken Neal. Kind of related indirectly to... I thought you were getting them walking out because I brought it up. Well, anyway, their dad, Ike Neal, was probably the best dude wrangler I ever knew on the bear paw. And the young Dudeens, the girls were Dudeens, as I keep pointing out, nobody else uses the word, the young Dudeens would usually get a crush on the wranglers. And the wranglers liked them just fine, but they needed a little space from time to time. And Ike had an invariably successful way of sort of breaking the crush without being cruel. One of the girls, or two, would go wrangling in the morning, horse wrangling, and five, and come in time for breakfast and ask if they could eat in the kitchen with the wranglers. And I could always say, why, sure. And go in and say, Cookie, put on another plate for so-and-so. And then they'd sit down and he'd say, coffee? Well, of course, these kids, they're going to be acting big with the right. Sure, they'd have coffee. And so he'd pour coffee in his cup and coffee in their cup. And then he'd say, sugar? And they'd usually, because they weren't coffee drinkers at that, say, yes, please, sugar. He'd just reach into the sugar bowl and take a handful of granulated sugar and put some in his coffee and some in the girls. Then he'd say, cream? please? And he'd pour some cream in theirs and in his, and then he'd take his finger was about this size. And he'd take his big finger and he'd put it in his coffee cup and stir it quick there and lick it off and put it in her coffee cup and stir it, and that did it. That's all it took. They never asked to come back for breakfast again. Well, Bob Kellogg over there, a friend of mine from the San Diego area, who's up here for a while, was here last week. He phoned his mother and challenged her to find a song I didn't know, and of course she did. It's one I'm going to learn and you're going to hear. But she asked him if I knew this song, so that's why I'm singing this song. Away up high in the Teton Peaks, where the yellow jack pines grow tall, old Sandy Bob and Buster Jiggs had a roundup camp last fall. They took their horses and the branding irons, maybe a dog or two, and aloud they'd brand every long-haired calf that came into their view. Now any old dogie with flap long ears that didn't push up by day got his long ears whittled and his old hide sizzled in a most artistic way. Now one fine day, says Buster Jiggs, as he throws his seago down, I'm getting tired of cowography, and allow I'm going to town. So he saddles up and he hits a lope, for it wasn't no sight of a ride. And them was the days when a good cowpunch could aisle up his insides. They starts it at the cowboy bar at the head of Whiskey Row. And it winds up down at the Wirt Hotel some 40 drinks below. They sets her up and he turns around and he goes her the other way. To tell you the honest, the goodness truth, them boys got slewed that day. As they was on their way to camp, packing a pretty good load, who should they meet but the devil himself come prancing down the road. He says, you ornery cowboy skunks, you better head hunt your holes, for I've come up from down below to gather in your souls. The devil be damned, says Sandy Sam, cause he's feeling pretty tight, and you'll not gather in any cowboy souls without one heck of a fight. So he punches a hole in his old seago and he throws it straight and true. He laps it on the devil's horns and he takes his dallies too. Now Buster Jiggs was a Riata man with his rawhide coiled up neat, but he shakes it out and he builds a loop and he ropes the old boy's hind feet. They tails him down and they stretches him out, and while her irons is getting hot, they crops him swallow, forks his ears and brands him up a lot. They prunes him up with a dehorning saw, and he knots his tail for a joke. And he rides off and leaves him there neck up to a blackjack oak. Now if you're ever up in the Teton Peaks and you hear an awful wail, you'll know it's the devil a bellerin' around about them knots that's in his tail. Thank you. Before I depart this scene, I just want to remind you all to have a very happy new year. And remember, everything in moderation, including moderation.
He stole that line. Jack Hyler, it's songs of the Wild West out here. We've got a fellow who also sings Western songs, was part of a swing band, the side channel swing band for quite a while. They played around here quite a bit. This is Greg Keckler.
Thank you. Every day along about evening, when the twilight's beginning to fade, I ride to the slumbering shadows along the Navajo Trail. When it's twilight and crickets are calling and coyotes are making a wail, I dream by a smoldering fire along but I love to lie and listen to the music while the wind is strumming a sagebrush guitar. While over yonder hill the moon is climbing, it always finds me wishing on a star. What do you know? It's morning already. There's a dawning so silver and pale. It's time to climb into my saddle and ride the Navajo Trail. But I love to lie and listen to the music while the wind is strumming a sagebrush guitar. While over yonder hill the moon is climbing, it always finds me wishing on a star. What do you know? It's morning already. There's a dawning so silver and pale. It's time to climb into my saddle and ride the Navajo Trail.
The Navajo Trail. Thank you.
Well, we won't subject you to too much cowboy music tonight. It's kind of a love song, comes from the 60s folk scene.
Greg Keckler, and next we have my co-hoot, as I like to call him, usually always starts the hoot off, but Bill has been very, very active in folk music around the valley here since the mid-50s, around 1956, I think he first came in here and started what were known in 1957 as the Teton Tea Parties. He had a job that summer working for the road construction crew that was building the highway on the east side of the valley going up to Moran from here. Used to be the road was right outside this window and the bridge was just right over here, and the road, the only highway through the valley, went right by the Chapel of the Transfiguration and up by Jenny Lake. And while they were building the road and after they had constructed the new bridge, the present bridge at Moose here, Bill found a very convenient tent that summer. That was the bridge. And he lived under the bridge on the east side of the river. And almost every night there were song fests down there. And Bill had a large cauldron that he would start some tea in, and then other people would bring by wine and sugar and lemons and other horrible things and drop into this. But it sure made for some nice warm folk songs around the campfire. Those were known as Teton Tea Parties, and then they migrated with Bill up to the Climbers Campground at the south end of Jenny Lake. And then since he was a guide for Exums, why, he had the Teton Tea Parties up on Guides Hill for a great many years. Has also been one of the original members of the Stagecoach Band. 27 years they've been doing it. This will be our fourth anniversary this coming February. So he's been involved in a couple of rather exciting musical evenings here in the valley. Please welcome Bill Briggs.
A little boy came up to me once, and he had heard about the story of living under the bridge, and he said, "Are you really a troll?"
What was the answer?
Mike Dowling was here a couple of weeks ago and played just marvelous music. And he played one song of Mississippi John Hurt's, which I really like, and I used to play it years ago, and I'm going to try again tonight for the first time. But it's a wonderful song. But it's, you know, about death and dying and all that sort of thing. That's typical.
Laid him away. Angels laid
6 feet under the clay, angels laid him away. Another song of death and dying here.
That was Bill Briggs, and you'll be seeing a lot of Bill tonight. He does most of the emceeing as the evening goes on. We keep track how many times different people perform here. And this next fellow came after the Hoot had been going on for about a year or so, and then has become a regular. He has a wonderful voice. Sometimes he does songs, he actually sounds like four different people singing, doing the whole song. He's pretty amazing that way. This is Patrick Troiani.
I've got an electronical problem, but we're unplugged here, so I'm going to sit down. And I'm going to bring Hank up with me, all right? Look at this. John said my button's out. I was looking at my jeans. That, I don't need it anyway. Okay, doesn't matter. Anyhow, I hope you all had a nice Christmas and in the future have a nice New Year tomorrow night. This is I'm gonna do a couple songs that I wrote. This is one called My Love Sleeps Tonight.
Burning light way over across the river. My love, she sleeps tonight, sleeps silent like an angel, clutching on her pillow. In her lonely dream, she smiles. Sleep silent like an angel, with beauty, grace, and style. How can I get to see her? For the night is so cold, and the river is so wide. When I did not care, I doubt if she would want me, for the pain is always there.
Hang on the door, bro.
And had I not been so foolish, mindly. Sadness lingers with me on and on and on and on. Bad memories remind me my lady love is gone. Way over across the river in a little log cabin with a burning light. Way over across the river, my love, she sleeps tonight.
Thank you. Thanks.
Okay. I don't know if I could do this song sitting down, but I'll try. A song I wrote a few years back about the weather, about raining, you know. And, since watching the Weather Channel today on my day off, that's my entertainment. I'm quite knowledgeable now, knowing that there is rain coming to this area. So I'm gonna sing a song about rain. It's called "It Don't Rain," so it's a paradoxical song. It don't rain in Georgia like it rains here. It might rain in California maybe twice a year. When it rains in Canada and I'm up there, well, that's enough for me. I'm going home. It don't rain in Tucson like it rains here. I don't know if you saw how it rained the other year. When it rains in Michigan, I end up getting sick again and going right back home. Traveling, rambling all around. No matter where I go, any city, state, or town, gradually I hear the sound of the rain that brings me pain. And it's the pain that brings me down. It don't rain in Portland like it rains here. I was told the rain in Portland lingers half the year. And when it rains in Idaho, I often wonder why I go away from my own home. When I was down in Kansas, well, it rained like hell right there. I don't understand this, it's been raining everywhere. From Tennessee to Dover, it's chasing me all over, and it keeps on pouring down. Everywhere, everywhere I go, no matter which direction that the whirly winds are gonna blow, every day, it's the rain inside that's killing me. I'd rather see some snow. Now it don't rain in Georgia like it rains here. It don't rain in Louisiana maybe twice a year. It don't rain in Georgia. It don't rain in Georgia. It don't rain in Georgia like it rains right here. It don't rain in Georgia like it rains right here. No, it don't rain in Georgia like it'll rain right here.
Thank you. I hope it snows.
That's our singing lift operator at Snow King. Patrick Troiani. Oh, he's good. All right, we've got another fellow that plays awfully well, sings awfully well, even writes awfully well. This guy's got talent. Played music with us for 10 years at the Stagecoach and does a wonderful job entertaining an audience. It's just marvelous to work with him. This is John Cook.
Thank you. This might be the first song I ever played at this Hootenanny, but that's too far back to remember. I was having trouble until today remembering the last day I didn't shovel snow. It was kind of a welcome relief, but I really hate to see rain on top of snow. It's just depressing, you know, soggy. This is called the Country Blues, and it was originally done on frailing banjo style, so this is kind of like, I kind of approximate that on the guitar.
dig me a hole in the meadow, good people. Gonna dig me a grave in the ground. You can come and mourn, good woman, and watch this rounder go down.
Stand up, okay. I'll stand up too. Hank's gonna pick along on this one, as you may have guessed. That last tune's in an A modal. Without tuning, you just finger it. It's a nice old-time sound. By adding just one little fret there, becomes A minor, which this song is in.
I can settle down, and I'm doing just fine, till I hear that old freight coming down the line. Then I hurry straight home, and I pack, and if I didn't go, I believe I'd blow my stack. Let me tell you, babe, you gotta understand. When the Lord made me, he made a rambling man. I love to see those towns pass by and arrive. Travel this land from the mountains to the sea, for that's the life I believe he meant for me. Sometimes it's hard, but you gotta understand, when the Lord made me, he made a rambling man. Travel this land from the mountains to the sea, 'cause that's the life I believe he made for me. And when I'm gone, stand. Just say God's called home his rambling man. I can settle down and I'm doing just fine till I hear that old freight rolling down the line. Let me tell you, babe, you gotta understand, when the Lord made me, he made a rambling man.
Thank you.
That's John Kirk, along with Hank Phibbs. All right, we've got this fellow, I'm happy to say, gave me the words for that. Angels laid him away, but he does himself a very good job of playing Mississippi John Hurt songs. A wonderful guitarist. This is Jerome Young.
Thank you. This thing goes on, the entertainment gets better and better and better. It gets harder to play here. Big crowd kind of helps to relax a little bit. It looks like a lot of nice folks in here, but I'm sure there's a few rednecks too. Did you hear the Jeff Foxworthy says, you may be redneck if you always thought that the last four words of the national anthem are, gentlemen, start your engines? Well, the first words your child learns are, attention, Kmart shoppers. I want to do a little song for you here. Sitting on top of the world. In the spring, one sunny day, my good gal left me. Oh, she went away. Now she's gone, I don't worry, but I'm sitting on top of her. She called me up down in El Paso. I'll come back, daddy, oh, I need you so. She's gone, I don't worry, 'cause I'm sitting on top. I don't like my peaches. Don't shake my tree, get out of my orchard, and stop bothering me. Oh, she's gone, I don't worry, but I'm sitting on top. I'm going down to the station, down in the yard. Going to catch me a freight train, I've been working too hard. Oh, she's gone, I don't worry, I'm sitting on top. Mississippi. She's deep and wide, and the girl I'm loving, she's on the other side. Now she's gone, I don't worry, but I'm sitting on top of her. My old pal, you know he done me wrong. He stole my woman with his old banjo. Now they're gone, I don't worry, but I'm sitting on top. Got a little time here to tune. That was in a straight D. If anybody wants to play that, it saves you a lot of trouble to get into that D tune. My 15-year-old daughter told me a joke, blonde joke. I know it's not real popular jokes these days, but it was so good, I gotta tell you this. I got a little time to tune here anyway. Seeing these three blondes come to this river. It was over the banks. They were all trying to figure out how they're gonna get across. They happened to find a little bottle in the fork of a tree there and had a genie in it. So they picked the bottle up. This one gal, she rubbed the bottle and the little genie came out. She says, what do you like? She says, I like to be twice as smart as I am. So I figured out how to get across this river. She went down and built a raft and went across. Second one rubbed the bottle. She says, I like to be smarter than that. So Jeannie gave her a wish. She went down and rented a boat. Rode across. The third one came up. She says, I want to be smarter than this. I want to be 10 times smarter than this. Because I can see this is a better way than this. And so she turned in to a man and walked across the bridge. House is divided, isn't it?
All right, Jerome.
My kid told me that joke. I'm not responsible. An old standard here. String stands for bad. I remember the night and the Tennessee wind, and I knew just how much I had lost. As I lost my little darling the night they were playing that beautiful Tennessee waltz. Here's a fiddle break.
Jerome Young. Oh, yeah. I used to think that the name of that song was the Tennis Shoe Waltz. Took me a long time to grow up to that one. Anyway, this is our next performer here is my co-hoot, and he is a wonderful ballad singer. Wonderful storyteller. Ballads are story, tales of things that have happened or maybe should have happened or whatever. But he tells them in such a way that it's really entertaining. This is Dick Barker.
Thank you. My notes on this song, I learned this in May of 1957. That's about the time that Bill and I, that summer, were swapping songs. But a friend of mine down at college at Colorado State University found this song in a book of lumberman ballads at the Colorado A&M. In fact, our first year there was still Colorado A&M. But he found this this song down there, and it's just a good example of a dialect song. This is called I Banis Veed. Well, I Banis Veed from Minnesota, and I work in the Northwood about 10 yar. I tank I go to St. Paula and Minneapolis to see what's there. Well, I buy me a suit, and I buy me a bottle, and I dress me up way out of sight. I jump on the tail of the Yimhill wagon, Jesus Christ, I feel for a fight. Well, I go down to the Salvation Army. Uh-oh, that's wrong. I go down to Seven Corner, where the Salvation Army play. And one of those women, she comes up to me, and what you think this woman say? She say, will you work for Jesus? And I say, how much a Jesus pay? And she say, Jesus, he no pay or nothing. And I say, I no work that day. Well, this next song is about another big winner. As a matter of fact, 123 years ago, 21 men left Provo, Utah for the gold fields down in southern Colorado. And it was an early fall, a heavy winter, and they got stranded in the mountains. The Ute Indians found them. They took them to Chief Ouray's camp. They told them they could spend the winter, but they were all sick. They had gold fever. So they pressed on towards Breckenridge, all but six of them. The sixth that stayed behind finally left on February 9th. 66 days later, one man came out of the hills alive. His name was Alfred Packer. And when he got down to town, why, he was spending a lot of money and gambling. When they questioned him about it, why, he told a rather grisly story about murder and cannibalism. So they threw him in jail. But they had to wait until next August for the snow to melt in the high country so they could get up there and look around. Finally, they found the five skeletons. That very night, he broke out of jail. Wasn't seen for 9 years until he was found up here in Wyoming. They took him back to Colorado, held trial for him. He claimed it was self-defense. He said he was coming back from hunting one morning, and when he got back to camp, he found that one of the others had killed the other four. And when he started after him, Packer said he shot him in self-defense. But the jury didn't buy it, and they sentenced him. When the judge finally read the condemnation speech, a long and a flowery speech, he told about the beautiful area where this terrible thing had happened and about the place that was untouched by the hand of man, just as the great artist had made it. He didn't lose his composure until right at the end when he looked at him and he says, "And Alfred Packer, I sentences you to be hung by the neck until you's dead, 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 and may God have mercy on your soul." Larry Dolan, local saloon keeper, ran out of the courtroom, ran down the street, ran into the first saloon, and he started yelling, "They're gonna hang old Packer." The judge, he says, "Stand up, you man-eating son of a gun. Stand up." And then, a pinting his fingers and a shaking so raging mad he was, he says, "Alfred Packer, I sentences you to be hung by the neck until you's dead, dead, dead. There was only seven Democrats in Hinsdale County, and you had five of them." In the Colorado Rockies, where the snow is deep and cold, and a man afoot can starve to death unless he's brave and bold. They tell of Alfred Packer, and some of them still rave about the Hinsdale County Democrats that never saw a grave. Old Packer set out on a trip with five of his old friends in the Colorado Rockies through the snow and howling wind. But the way was long and weary, and the food got mighty short. But Alfred had his dinner of the very last resort. "Oh, Alfred Packer, you'll surely go to hell. While all the others starved to death, you dined a bit too well." Old Packer, fat and healthy, come down into the plains. He was lonely, he was horny, but he had no stomach pains. When he told his story, well, it made the strong men pale. So they grabbed old Alfred Packer and they flung him into jail. They brought old Packer to the court, and they had a speedy trial. A gory tale it was he told that went into the file. The testimony shook the judge, who trembled where he sat. He was horrified, but then, of course, he was a Democrat. "Oh, Alfred Packer, please tell me for my sake, did the Hinsdale County Democrats give you a tummy ache?" And his lawyer said, "Old Packer didn't kill him. He just ate him when they died. so they couldn't call it murder or even fratricide. But they sent old Al to prison to settle up his debt for all the voting Democrats that Alfred Packer had. When the judge pronounced the sentence, he was in a righteous rage, and the words he said can still be read upon the yellered page. He wished that he could hang old Al until completely dead. So when he banged the gavel, 'twas in anger that he said, "Oh, Alfred Packer, you should be skinned alive. There was only 7 Democrats, and you bastard, you get 5.
Thank you.
I never know whether to believe him or not. Dick Barker. Oh, it's always a wonderful time to have a fellow come by and sing for us. He's it's a charming voice. He's a wonderful guitar player. Sang songs professionally down in Colorado. And came up here, and we got him into the Hootenanny here early on, and he played for us many, many times. Great music. He's gone back to Colorado. He's a professor down at university down there. Please welcome back Eric Stone.
I know you writer gonna miss me when I'm gone. I know you writer gonna miss me when I'm gone. Gonna miss your daddy rolling in your arms. Well, I laid down last night and I could not take my rest. Down last night and I could not take my rest. Yeah, my thoughts kept wandering like wild geese in the west. I know you rider gonna miss me when I'm gone. I know you rider gonna miss me when I'm gone. Miss your daddy rolling in your arms. Now the sun's gonna shine in my back door someday. The sun's gonna shine my back door someday. And the wind's gonna rise, blow my blues away.
It's an old traditional song, actually. It's gone through several different ramifications. Everybody from the Grateful Dead to James Taylor has done the song. But I had to change one verse just to get my 2 cents in. Here it goes.
Well, I wish I were a headlight on a northbound train. Wish I were a headlight on a northbound train. Well, I'd shine my light through the cool Colorado rain. And I love my baby, she's bound to love me some. I said I love my baby and she's bound to love me some. She does the most amazing things with her big toe and her thumb.
miss me when I'm gone. Which part do you think was mine? I know you right are gonna miss me when I'm gone. Gonna miss your daddy rolling in your arms. Gonna miss your daddy rolling in your arms. Gonna miss your daddy rolling in your arms. Josef, how you doing tonight? It's good to see you. I don't know whether to be Norwegian or Scottish tonight, but I think I'll try Irish. This is one I sort of owe Dick for not having done many times before. Dick forgot to mention that down at the University of Colorado where I teach, is in a student union, is a snack bar, really just a hamburger joint called the Alfred Packer Grill. That's right.
I knew that.
Yep. See, Dick's an alumni of Colorado State University, and so am I. So I don't know. My allegiances are torn. I don't know whether that's a good thing to be proud of or, you know, something to keep under the rug. The CU Bison. Yeah. That's their football team, the CU Bison. No, it's not. CU Buffaloes. I tried to tell them. I'm a wildlife biologist by training, and they just don't listen to me anymore. I was headed home one night on the sea. Swaying in my hammock, I fell asleep. I dreamed a dream. Thought it true, a dream of Franklin, and his gallant crew. The 100 seamen he sailed away, to the frozen ocean in the month to seek a passage around the pole. For us poor seamen, sometimes our goal through cruel hearts ships is mended strong. The ships on mountains of ice were broke. Only the Eskimo with his skin thin was the only one who ever came in. Dick's always been proud of knowing the history behind this, and he keeps pretty good records of what happens in the latest research. Did you know that there was an old diary that was discovered not too many years ago of a priest on somewhere up in northern Canada who had interviewed an Eskimo who had blonde hair and blue eyes. And when asked who his parents were, he said, well, my mother was an Inuit, and my father came from a great big ship. This was in 1859. The ship belonged to Lord Franklin, who left England in 18... Help me out here, Dick. It's probably the 1840s or 30s. And was never heard from again, except lots of rumors among the Eskimo that Anglos had come to live with them for a time, but had all died. More recently, they discovered remains of humans on some desolate islands in the North Sea. And all of those remains contained unusual quantities of lead, and they theorized that the party got stranded on an iceberg or stranded in the pack ice. Rescued by Eskimos, they kept eating their stored food that they took with them off the ship and died from lead poisoning from the solder that would seal the cans of food that they had. But to this day, no one still knows what exactly happened to Lord Franklin and his crew. Down in Buffin Bay, where the whale fishes blow, the fate of Franklin no man may know. The fate of Franklin, oh, no tongue can tell. Franklin low, but the sailors do dwell. Now my body, it brings me pain. My long lost Franklin, I would trust remain. 10,000 pounds I'd freely give to hear on earth Lord Franklin asleep. I dreamed a dream and I thought it true concerning Franklin and his gallant crew.
A little bit of history. Before I came out here, I went to Dartmouth College, and we had a fellow there who was an oceanographer, and he would have in all the explorers of the Arctic come by, and he'd invite us over, and we'd all sing songs, and that's where I got started in folk music. And we'd sing songs, a lot like that, but boy, it reminds me of those days. Eric Stone, marvelous job. We've got a new guy. Yeah, go ahead. We've got a new fellow here. His first time with us. He's from Cincinnati, Ohio. Plays guitar. This is Ed Stanny.
I've spent the past week driving my Jeep from Cincinnati, made it eventually to here, stopped in a couple places, stopped in Alton, Illinois, stopped in Kansas City for a little while, and I stopped in Vail, Colorado, supposed to be about a week, and I got tired of it in about 2 days. And then I came up here, and the people in this part of the country, and particularly this part of Wyoming, are the nicest people I've met so far. It's just wonderful. America seems to be infatuated with automobiles, and I have to say that I'm one of those people infatuated. I have, over the course of my lifetime, I've probably owned 5 or 6 of them, and I'm sure that most of you have, too. You drive the car, and you put a lot of miles on it, and you fix it, or maybe you don't fix it, maybe you trade it in, maybe you lease it, maybe you get a new one. You never really stop to think about what happens to the last car you had. This is the song that your last car would sing, all right? Well, it don't look all that ragged for all the time that's been. But I'm weakened underneath me where my frame has rusted thin. This year's state inspection I just barely passed. Won't you drive me across the country, boy? This year could be my last. I'm a tail fin raw locomotive from the days of cheap gasoline. I'm full sail by the side of the road. I'm going nowhere, a rusty old American dream. I rolled off the line in Detroit back in 1968. 3 days on the showroom floor, well, that's all I had to wait. I've been good to all who own me, so have no fear. Come on, boy, put your money down and get me out of here. 'Cause I'm a tail fin road locomotive from the days of cheap gasoline. I'm for sale by the side of the road, going nowhere, a rusty old American dream. This car needs a young man to own him, one who will polish the chrome. I will give you the rest of my lifetime, just don't let me die here alone. You just jump me some juice in the battery, give that old starter a spin. Hear me whir, sputter, backfire through the carburetor and roar into life once again. 'Cause I'm a tail fin raw locomotive. Now you can polish my chrome so clean. We can fly off into the sun, set together a rusty old American dream. I'm still running, I'm a rusty old American dream. Thank you. Thank you. Gets a little out of tune sometimes. I'm feeling set apart from the crowd tonight in a couple of ways. First of all, I'm from the East Coast, and it seems like most of the wonderful people that have played before me are from west of the Mississippi. Secondly, I'm wearing brown jeans, and everybody else has been wearing blue jeans. Thirdly, I'm wearing a polo shirt, and I believe plaid seems to be the uniform. And I want to try and set myself apart in one more positive way, and that is to bring up a combination of instruments that I don't think you've heard tonight. That is to bring up my friend Heather, who has a lovely voice, and is going to sing some harmony with me. That last song was in open C, so I also have to do some retuning. And I have a blonde joke, but I'm not going to tell it.
Smart. I die, come on, you know.
Telling jokes is always a good idea while you tune, because then you don't have to be embarrassed when you have a hard time tuning.
Trailed by 20 hounds. Didn't get to sleep last night till the morning came around. Set out running, gonna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. And if I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. Ran into the devil, baby, and loaned me 20 bills. Spend the night in Utah in a cave up in the hills. Set out running, gonna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. Ran down to the levee, but the devil caught me there. Took my $20 bill and then he vanished in the air. Set out running, gonna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. Got two reasons why I cry away each lonely night. The first one's named Sweet Anne Marie, and she's my heart's delight. Second one is prison, and the sheriff's on my trail. If he catches up with me, well, I'll spend my life in jail. I got a wife in Chino, I've got one in Cherokee. First one says she's got my child, but it don't look like me. Set out running, gonna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. And if I get home before daylight, just might get some sleep tonight. One more. Set out running, gonna take my time. Friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight.
Super job. It's Heather. I didn't get her last name, but Ed Santee. I gotta get that right. Santee. All right. Hey, it's time we take a break, and we'll have us go through this all again. Just stick around. We'll be back in 10 minutes.
Caught me by surprise. I just had my guitar here. I was gonna back some people up if they wanted some help, but do a couple songs here, have some fun. Well, I was new in town. I just pulled in. I was looking for the house of a dear old friend, but just how to reach the place was still the question. So I passed an old man on the street. I said, hey friend, excuse me please, but I wonder if you give me some directions. Well, I told him the address and he said, yes, I know what you want to do, but I'm a little fuzzy-minded part of the time, so let me think this thing through. Well, he began to mumble and he scratched his chin and he snapped his fingers and he said with a grin, said, okay, son, here's all you gotta do. You go north, take a left on South Wright Street, go up the hill to Down Avenue, turn left at the corner of Circle Square, then right on Left Ridge Lane. Take a left-hand fork at Spooner Road, then Easy Avenue to Hardin Boulevard, turn back to your left on Wright Front Street, and it's right down there on your left. Well, I did what he said as best I could, and I thought I was doing pretty darn good. I'd made every turn except the final one. Then I made the last turn of the drive, and I swear I just couldn't believe my eyes. I was right back at the place I'd started from. And there at the corner, feeding the birds with a smile upon his face, stood that old man whose directions began my recent wild goose chase. So I went up to him, and a friend said, hey, friend, could you give me those directions again? He said, sure, here's all you do to reach the place. You go north, take a left on South Wright Street, go up the hill to Down Avenue, turn left at the corner of Circle Square, then right on Left Ridge Lane. Take a left-hand fork at Spooner Road, then Easy Avenue to Hardin Boulevard, turn left on your right on Wright Front Street, and it's right down there on your left. Ah, but that's just what I did, I said, and I wound up back here instead of getting to the place I had in mind. Since I'm right here, all I can say is there must be some other way to get me to the place I had in mind. Well, he said, no, the way you go is the way I told you to. And if this isn't where you want to be, well, there's nothing I can do. 'Cause that address you gave to me is right over there across the street. I can get you to here, but the rest is up to you. You go north, take a left on South Wright Street, go up the hill to Down Avenue, turn left at the corner of Circle Square, then right on a Left Ridge Lane. Take a left-hand fork at Spooner Road, then Easy Avenue to Hardin Boulevard, turn back to your left on Wright Front Street, it's right down there on your left. Go north, take a left on South Wright Street, go up the hill to Down Avenue, turn left at the corner of Circle Square, then right on Left Ridge Lane. Take a left and fork at Spooner Road, then Easy Avenue to Hardin Boulevard, turn back to your left on Wright Front Street, it's right down there on your left.
The versatile Matt Montaigne. Hey, we'll have back with us our second performer this evening. Plays Western songs, but he occasionally puts in some other stuff for us too. This is Greg Keckler.
There are people in this room that actually thought my last name was Locksmith. That's only what I do to support my wife's horse habits. But I enjoy it. All of it. My name is Longino de Castro. My father was a Spanish grandee. I won my wife in a card game. To hell with those lords or the sea. Well, the South Coast is a wild coast and lonely. You might win in a game at Hulong, but a lion still rules the barranca, and a man there is always alone. In a card game at Hulong, I played with an hombre named Juan. And after I'd taken his money, I staked all against his daughter Dawn. Well, I picked up the ace I had won her. My heart was down at my feet. jumped up to my throat in a hurry. Like a young summer's day, she was sweet. He opened the door to the kitchen, and he called the girl out with a curse, saying, take her, goddammer, you've won her. She's yours now for better or worse. Well, the South Coast is a wild coast and lonely. You might win in a game at Toulon, but a lion still rules the barranca, and a man there is always alone. Well, her arms had to tighten around me as we rode down the hills to the south. Not a word did I hear from her that day, not a kiss from her pretty young mouth. Ah, but that was a gay, happy winter. We carved on a cradle of pine by the fire in that neat little shanty, and I sang with that gay wife of mine. Ah, but the South Coast is a wild coast and lonely. You might win in a game at Toulon, but a lion still rules the barranca, and a man there is always alone. That night, I got hurt in a landslide. Crushed hip and twice broken bones. She saddled her pony like lightning and rode off for the doctor in Toulon. The lion screamed in the barranca. Bucky bolted and fell on his side. My young wife lay dead in the moonlight. My heart died that night with my bride. Well, the South Coast is a wild coast and lonely. You might win in a game at Toulon, but a lion still rules the barranca, and a man there is always alone.
That was Greg Keckler, and next we have that guy who's been on stage most of the evening back up here. This is Bill Briggs.
I don't play both of them at once. Things are coming to an end of the year here, so I'm singing songs about coming to the end. Tonight, here's another one. This is Southern Appalachian. Sitting in her high hall door, combing out her long yellow hair. Along came William and his new made bride, riding by so near. She threw down her ivory comb, tossed back her long yellow hair, bid him a fond farewell, I'll never again go there. so lately in the night. And they were fast asleep. Lady Margaret appeared all dressed in white, standing at their bed feet. How do you like your snow white pillow? How do you like your sheet? How do you like the fair young lady lies in your arms asleep? It's well I like my snow white pillow, better I like my sheet, best I like the fair young lady stands at my bed feet. He's called to him his servant man, saddle the dapple roan, rode till he came to Lady Margaret's home, knocked on the door alone. Is Lady Margaret in her room? Is she in the hall? No, she's lying in a cold clay coffin, face turned to the wall. First he kissed her cold clay lips, then he kissed her chin, then he kissed her lily white breast, where love did enter in. Margaret was sitting in her high hall door, combing out her long yellow hair. Along came William and his new made bride, riding by so near.
An Austrian song. Now it's a hunting accident that occurred with the Archduke Johann. This is a yodel that was a well-loved character, evidently.
Thank you.
Bill Briggs always has at least one yodel every Monday night. Next we have that guy with a fantastic voice. Don't know what he's going to do this time, but this is Patrick Troiani. Sometimes some of the best music seems to be going on downstairs. These guys are practicing and getting ready.
We're having a party down in the wine cellar.
Oh! Good news, Bob. Good news.
Bring the band up, Dick.
Okay, here he is, Patrick Troiani.
Okay, thank you. I'm sorry for the delay, but okay. We were working a bunch of...
Angel from Montgomery, you're set second, right?
What?
Angel from Montgomery, and you're set second, right?
Angel from Montgomery, yes, huh?
Right, yes, after this song.
Negotiated
what
music.
What do I do now? Do the one you just did.
See, we were working downstairs with a bunch of musicians. We had a great band going.
And it disintegrated.
And, but there are certain rules about certain people being up here. Now, John just told me what to do and I forgot.
Do those two you just did downstairs.
Starting with?
Dylan.
Okay, come on, Hank. What up, Aaron? Yes, please. I'm so confused, it really...
This is what the Hootenanny's all about.
Anyway, this is what we were doing downstairs and we brought it up. So, this is an old song called I'll Be Your Baby Tonight.
Thank you.
know that big fat moon's gonna shine like a spoon, and we're gonna let it, you know, we won't regret it. Kick your shoes off, do not fear. Bring that bottle on over here. I'll be your baby tonight. Don't you know?
I still don't know what's going on. Age of, okay, okay.
We're bending the rules a little bit, but...
Is this allowed? I don't know. Are we going to get fined?
Hey, keep you in the band together.
Oh, sorry. Okay, welcome all these guys up here. They're helping me out because I have no idea what I'm doing.
Angel from Montgomery.
That's what we're doing.
Oh, yeah.
Wait till you hear what we're doing in my set.
Am I included in this?
Yes.
Oh, Christ.
My mother, the old man's another jerk that's grown old. If dreams were lightning, thunder was burning desire, this old house might have burnt down such a long, long time ago. Help me out now. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I could hold on to. To believe in this living's such a hard way. I was a young girl, I had me this cowboy. He wasn't very much to look at, but he was a free rambling man. That was a long time. No matter how hard that I ever do try, the years seem to flow by just like a busted down dam. Yes indeed, made me an angel. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I could hold on to. To believe in this living is a hard way to go.
ahead, John.
There's flies in the kitchen. I could hear every one of them buzzing. And I ain't done a damn thing since I woke up today. It's not unusual. How the hell could a person go to work every morning, come back home in the evening, and don't have a damn word to say? Yeah.
Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I can hold on to. To believe in this living is a hard way to go. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing I can hold on to believe in this living is a hard way to go. To believe in this living is a hard way.
Call this group the Monks or the Wine Cellar Quintet.
Dornan's downtown band.
All right, Patrick Troiani and Company. One of which we'll get right back up here. John Cook.
Eric's going to help me out on this.
This is unrehearsed.
Yeah, we were rehearsing that other one, so. DFD, how does that sound to you?
Okay, I may not do the guitar part. I'll just do the vocals.
Okay, any place you want, just.
Old Mary took to running with a traveling. Left her mama crying with her head in her hands. Such a sad case, so brokenhearted. She said, mama, gotta go, gotta get out of here. Gotta get out of town, tired of hanging around. Gotta roll on between the ditches. It's just an ordinary story about the way things go. Round and round, nobody knows, but the highway goes on forever. That old highway goes on forever. Well, she never would have done it if she hadn't got drunk, hadn't started running with a traveling man, if she hadn't started taking those crazy chances. She said, daughter, let me tell you about the traveling kind. Everywhere they go in such a very short time, he'll be long gone before you know it. He'll be long gone before you know it. She said, never ever known it when it felt so good. Never ever knew it when I knew I could. Never ever done it when it looked so right. Leaving Louisiana in the broad daylight. Alligator bait and the bars don't close. It's the real thing. down in Louisiana. Did you ever see a Cajun when he really got mad? Really got trouble like a daughter gone bad. It gets real hot down in Louisiana. Well, a stranger better move it or he's gonna get killed. Gonna have to get it or a shotgun will. It ain't no time for lengthy speeches. It ain't no time for lengthy speeches. She said, never ever known it when it felt so good. Never ever knew it when I knew I could. Never ever done it when it looked so right. Leaving Louisiana in the broad daylight. Never ever known it when it felt so good. Never ever knew it when I knew I could. Never ever done it when it looked so right. Leaving Louisiana in the broad daylight. Leaving Louisiana in the broad daylight. It's just an ordinary story about the way things go. Round and round, nobody knows but the highway. Goes on forever. There ain't no way to stop the water.
Oh, I forgot. Eric Stone, thank you. And now. Also unreviewed, at least. We've done it before, but
starting to get the gist of this whole deal here. What key to do this?
The gist of this whole deal is this working out like a hootenanny tonight, you know, where you just sort
that's
of
right, that's right.
Make it up as you go along and play together in the basement and try to bring it up here.
It's good energy.
You know what a hootenanny was originally? It was a bunch of people sitting around a living room sort of trading songs in a circle, you know. And this is a fair approximation. We really like this living room. It's the Dornan's living room. It's a real nice one.